Okay, welcome to the Facility Management 2010 show in Earls Court in London. I'm James from iSight Innovation Labs, and I'd like to show you just some new technologies that we didn't have 10 months ago and we have now, taken from aerospace, automotive, industrial, and all these technologies, and we're looking at how we can apply them to the facility management arena. So let's talk about sensing first. Right now we can actually detect dust very, very accurately using this particular dust sensor, and a combination of this dust sensor with a low power radio module combined with some repeaters to cover a complete building onto a GPRS or a 3G network allows us to give a web display of where dust is gathering at what time in any location. And this is very good applications in facility management for predictive maintenance. When do you need to clean? What areas do you need to clean more often? We can do gas sensing. Gas sensing technology has come a long way. It was difficult a few years ago to detect certain gases in moist environments, and now by heating techniques and different sensing technologies, we've overcome most of these. So we can detect most types of gases as well as dust. RFID has been around for a long time, and we use RFID as a low-cost means of identifying when people arrive to start a job and to finish a job. It's an alternative to barcodes. The advantage of an RFID tag over a barcode is that you can't photocopy an RFID tag. So somebody, it does actually prove that somebody has been there when they say they have been there. But the RFID tags come in various types and forms. And what's the new types of RFID tags that we have now? We have these small RFID tags that are actually laundry proof. So you can actually put them onto your clothes. So for laundrettes, etc., hospitals, we can actually tag. And what's happening in the technology of RFID tags is we have software that does anti-collision software, which means we're not restricted to reading one RFID tag at a time. We can have a bunch of RFID tags in a bag, and we can discriminate between one and the other. So in the laundry applications that I just gave a few seconds ago, you can have a complete bag of clothes and you can identify them as they go along on a conveyor belt or as they go into your laundry truck or whatever, and that's very good for facility management. Another type of sensing that we couldn't do this time last year is we have been able to do capacitive sensing for quite a while. So if we take this example here, which is a very small microcontroller chip, and we're using this as a capacitive sensor. So as I bring my hand close to it, you can see the light comes on. So it's detecting my body by capacitive methods. And this has been around for a little while, but what's new in this technology is there are newer methods where we can actually do this through plastic. And if we have a look at this unit here, I'll bring it close to the microphone so you might be able to hear the beeps. So it's detecting the mic capacitance through the plastic. And that in itself wouldn't be a fantastic innovation. What's a newer one is now, we can actually detect true metal. And this is a very good application in facility management where you have equipment that you need to power wash. So we just a complete metal in2Sequence panel with some numbers on it. And as I press the buttons, now this is not using the same method of capacity. You don't need to. I'll do it with a plastic pen, and you can see it still actually works. So it's not using my body capacitance to do it. What it's doing is there are tiny movement in the metal plate when I push it, and it measures that tiny micron of a movement. And this can be done very successfully with a very low cost device. And the in2Sequence labs are integrating those into our sensor portfolio, which goes back onto our web-based software. That's capacitance done. Now, another thing that we need to do that has changed that we couldn't do 10 months ago. 10 months ago, if we wanted to have a nice graphics display, it was expensive. The reason it was expensive is because the display manufacturers, typically Taiwanese companies, they brought out a display, they brought out their own controller chip, a second company brought out an interface chip to their controller chip, and then you went into interface to that. So there were four items in a display solution. Now, with advances in software and electronic design, that's been down to two. A single microcontroller chip can actually drive the display. So this is an example here of our in2Sequence washroom check, where somebody can say there's debris in the urinal, seat is damaged. They just a simple push button onto the graphics on here, and that goes to our radio network, through the GPRS network, onto our web-based system. So if somebody arrives, you can get your reports back from this display. And that's something that we couldn't have done 10 months ago because it was too expensive. But now the costs are coming down, that it's appropriate that almost every facility can have these low-cost solutions. The other thing that has new in the last probably 10 months is predictive maintenance. When you've got a system where you've got motors, when the bearings go on these motors, you get an increase in vibrations. I'll just demonstrate that with the little iPhone application here. We've got a motor just down here, and I'm putting a clip on the edge of it. And the clip on the edge of it is an extra piece of weight that's going to simulate a bearing failure. And when I do that, if you have a look at the display on the iPhone, you can see that there are oscillations on it. Now, if I was to take away the clip, which would simulate not having a bearing fault, you'll see that it's a fairly clear signal, fairly straight across. I can demonstrate that in a few more minutes on the iPad, which is a larger device. But the purpose of this demonstration is to say that we can predict failure on motors, and being able to predict that, then we can schedule our maintenance, and the savings can be very good. Now, but obviously every motor can't have an iPhone, but the technology used in the iPhone is accelerometer technology, and because all of these devices are so popular, the cost has come down. And for a few dollars, you can get one of these accelerometer devices, and we can interface those to our microcontroller, and we can display. So if I go up and down, you can hear the display, and I've just got a little XY axis on here, and that's displaying my XY coordinates. The iPhone is best to display the effect of the motor, but this is just the idea on here. So we can sense vibration, we can do an analysis of the vibration, so we can detect what type of failure it's going to be. We can put that onto our in2Sequence network, and then our facility management decision makers can see the graphs, where is the predictive maintenance going to be, and they can schedule what they need to do in the future. And so thank you very much for listening to the presentation.